أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين جزاكم الله خير فركم وبارك الله فيكم أن أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى Accept our own good deeds. The last time summary of it, because I like to connect you with whatever and remind whatever was taken before. Then we connect it to whatever we are in, still with the Salah, and still with coming to the house of Allah and being alive when you come to the house of Allah. Your heart will be alive. Your mind will be alive. You will purify your own self. And the last time was about al-Jum'ah and the etiquette of al-Jum'ah, and to be forgiven from Jum'ah to another Jum'ah, taking the shower, summary of all the hadith, taking the shower, purify yourself, put some perfume, wear the best of your clothes, come walking if you are able, with tranquility, no running, and also when you come enter the masjid, do not cross the people, try to sit in a place, if there is a place empty for you, also do not harm or do not insult anyone, do to rak'ah, تحية المسجد, even the Imam doing the khutbah, because hadith of Sulaik, and then after that sit and listen to the khutbah and be near to the Imam, and there is no sunnah qabliya to the Jum'ah. Then we move to hadith of al-A'ma, the blind man in Muslim, Abu Dawood, Ibn Majah and others. Also the total of it, a man, blind man, came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, Ya Rasulullah, there is no anybody to bring me to the masjid, and I am not able to bring every time somebody, and I am, as you see, blind man, and my home very far from your masjid. And it is in another narration, آخر المدينة أعلى الجبل, at the end of المدينة, and at the top of the mountain, there is no anyone bringing me. And you know, he was saying to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know that in المدينة, at that time, at the mountains and all of that, full of or a lot of wild animals and scorpions and dangerous things. Then in my way also the trees and the stones, if I crash in one of them, I will die. Is there any permission for me to pray at my home? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you hear al-azan? You know the time of the prayer? Said, yes, then you have to come to the prayer. I have no any rukhsa. No any permission for you. And in another narration, say, فَأْتِهَا وَلَوْ حَبْوًا, come to the prayer, the jama'ah, even crawling. Means not only all of this reason you have, even crawling, come. And also, if it is allowed, he will say to him, see some people, they pray in your area. He does not say that. He says, come to the masjid, house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is the excuse, the people say, I have my family, and you can pray jama'ah. Then every family pray jama'ah, and their home masjid will be completely empty. No, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he say to him, go and see some people in your place, you can pray with them, we will say, okay, Rasulullah already allow him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say to him, come to the masjid. And this is saying not only to that blind man, to every single Muslim, come to the house of Allah, make the house of Allah. Make yourself alive when you come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Purify yourself, you will learn, you will be prepared, and you will be taken a very highly rewarded. Nothing is free. Nothing is free. From the intention from your home to come to the house of Allah, that intention rewarded, coming is rewarded, reaching to the masjid is rewarding, entering the masjid with the dua is rewarded, and also the praying tahiyat al-masjid is rewarding, hearing the azan or saying it very highly rewarded, between al-azan and al-qama, the dua is acceptable, every single step, after the iqam and bring with the jama'ah 27 degree or 25, after the salah itself, that dua between azan and iqama is acceptable and it is never rejected, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, after the salah, subhanallah 33 times, alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 33 times, then if you read ayat al-kursi, the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, nothing prevent you from entering al-jannah except if you die. Nothing prevent you from entering al-jannah except if you die. How much you want more than this? Subhanallah. And this is not only in one prayer, not the other. Not only about al-Jum'ah. In every single prayer to you come to the house of Allah. Allah himself will feel happy when you come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we stop the last time with hadith of Muslim, book of al-Tahara. Hadith number 534 and 223, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, purification half of iman, alhamdulillah will fill the mizan, subhanallah walhamdulillah, if you repeat it will fill whatever between the heaven and the earth. Then the point is related to our topic, was-salatu nur. Salah is light. And this is an explanation of it. Salah is light means itself will give you light in this worldly life, light for you in the grave, light for you in the hereafter. Imagine if the electricity gun, the power gun, and you are sitting in a dark, you will need some light. Imagine in the grave, no any bulb, no anything, no any sun even, except your salah. Salah is one of the source of the light for you in your grave. Salah one of the source of the light for you in the hereafter. Salatu nur also will prevent you from committing any haram or wrong or mistakes. Salah also, light means a guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the right, to the halal, to the good, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your salah. The reward of it also, it will be a light for you in your chest, will open your chest for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَالصَّدَقَةُ burhan. Sadaqah is a proof for you that you have an iman, proof for you that really you love Allah Azza wa Jal, proof that you want to follow sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَالصَّبْرُ دُيَاءُ. And sabr, being sabr, will be also a light for you, one of the sources of the light. وَالْقُرْآنُ حُجَّةٌ لَكَ أَوْ عَلَيْكَ. Quran either a proof and plea for you or against you. Either the Quran will come defend you in front of Allah Azza wa Jal and in the hereafter and will be a reason for you to get the shafa'ah, or will be against you. Oh, Allah neglect me, oh, Allah does not understand me, oh, Allah does not spend a time to know what Allah wants, because this is your constitution, to know what Allah wants from you. This is your law. And contain everything with the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, كل الناس يغدو فبايعوا نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها. Everybody will work. Either you will save yourself with the work you do, if it is halal and right and good and according to the Quran and sunnah, or you will destroy your own self. Also, another ahadith about the wisdom and about the reward you will get when you come to the Masajid of Allah, that one of the main reason, one of the reason of entering al-Jannah is the Salat Sin. Tirmizi 615, Hadith Sahih, Imam Ahmad al-Hakim, narrated by Abu Umamah al-Bahili, قال, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he doing khutbah in Hajjah al-Wada', in the farewell Hajjah, that he said, اتقوا الله ربكم, fear Allah your Lord. Then after that what? وصلوا خمسكم, and pray your 5 daily prayer. Imagine if you are not able to do 5, what about 50? It was at the beginning, before Al-Isra wal Mi'raj, when he went to Allah, in Al-Isra wal Mi'raj, when he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ordered 50. Or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it so easy with the same reward. Make it 5. And here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, pray your 5 daily prayer. وَصُومُوا شَهْرَكُمْ. And pray your 5 day and fast, your months, which it is Ramadan. وَأَدُّوا زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. And do your zakah. وَأَطِيعُوا ذَا أَمْرَكُمْ. And obey the people who are in charge. And this is majority of the tafasir, saying the people who of the religion. Imam al-Bukhari and others, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he say, إِن لَمْ يَكُنُوا الْأَئِمَّةُ وَالْعُلَمَاءُ فَلَا أَعْلَمُ غَيْرَهُمْ. He said, if it's not the imams and alim, the Uli al-Amr in this ayah, in ayat of Al-Quran and in this ahadith, he said, I don't know any other one. Those are the people who will lead you to Al-Jannah, and what is greater than Al-Jannah? Here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, obey them as long as they are ordering you what Allah say and what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. And the ahadith about that point itself is a lot. إِنَّمَا جُعْلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. Imam is to be followed. فَلَا تَخْتَلِفُوا عَلَيْهِ. Do not be different than him. وَالْإِمَامُ رَاعٍ وَمَسْؤُولٍ. Imam is caretaker and the responsible, and many other ahadith. Then at the end of this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that تَدْخُلُوا جَنَّةَ رَبِّكُمْ. If you do that, you will enter al-Jannah. One of it related to our topic is صَلُّوا خَمْسَكُمْ. One of the reasons if entering al-Jannah, pray the 5 daily prayer with the other ahadith will be better and will be highly rewarded, and you will get whatever you will not be able to get it while you are alone if you pray in jama'ah in the masjid. And in another ahadith, the first thing you will be account about in the day of judgment, it is the Salah. First thing you will be asked about it is the Salah. And not only the Salah for the Fard. Look to the importance of the voluntary. Not only the Fard and the Sunnah. Voluntary also, because whatever missing of the Fard will be complete from the voluntary. Whatever broken, you did not do it perfectly, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in this hadith, and I'll mention it, look to his voluntary salah. And if it's something good of it, take it and perform and complete whatever missing and whatever is not perfect and complete in his fara'in. In Abu Dawood, Babu Qawlu Nabi, Kullu Salatin La Yutummuha Sahibuha Tatumum Tatawwa. It is a chapter in Abu Dawood, hadith number 864 and 227. The chapter name, every salah, you did not perfect it from the further sunan, Allah will order the angel to perfect it and complete it from your tatawwa. What about if you don't do voluntary? If you are not doing any voluntary, then from where they will perfect it? And if you do the voluntary also broken and not perfect and no khushu' and no perfect ruku', no perfect sujood, then do not blame except your own self. In Tirmidhi also, hadith number 413, in Nasa'i 464, Ibn Majah, Imam Ahmad and other, an Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu. He said, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, إن أول ما يحاسب عليه العبد يوم القيامة من عمله صلاته. The first thing you will be account from all of your deeds. First thing they will choose to account you is your salah. فإن صالحت, if it is good and perfect and complete, and you do خشوع and ركوع, and you know how to do and what to do and what to say in ركوع, what to say in سجود, what to say when you say سمع الله لمن حمد ربنا ولك الحمد, and what to say in the after تكبيرة الإحرام. You study it as you study anything in your life, and you try to perfect it and complete it. Salah is not only whatever you learn back home from the general people who doesn't study. No, you have to know it, and you have to know the arkan of it, the pillars of it, the sunan of it, what to do before it, what to do after it, what to do inside it. For that if it is complete and perfect, فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَحَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say he will be the most successful. Alhamdulillah. And the rest will be dealt with the same. فَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ. What about if it is spoiled? No ruku', no complete ruku'. He did ruku', but he does not complete it by tuma'nina, by taking time in ruku'. He did sujood, or she did sujood, but does not complete the sujood as it should be done. As I said to you, for the ruku', should be the back straight, and doing ruku' perfect and complete. إِنْ فَسَدَتْ, if you spoil it. And you spoil one ruku' and one sujood and one rak'ah and two rak'ah, and you don't know how many rak'ah you pray, and you are so busy when you are praying, then you spoil it yourself. And it's not a complete and perfect salah. فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرْ. He lose a lot. He is the most loser one. فَإِنْ انْتَقَصَ مِنْ فَرِيضَتِهِ شَيْءٍ. Still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always Allah is so merciful. If there is some shortening in his farida, listen from the fard. If there is any shortening in the fard, قال الله عز وجل, Allah عز وجل will say to the angel, انظروا هل لعبدي من تطوع. Look to my slave, does he have some voluntary prayer? فيكمل بها من تقص من الفريضة. They will complete whatever shortening in the fard from the voluntary. Listen, they will complete whatever shortening, whatever broken, whatever not complete, whatever not perfect in fara'id. Fard like Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, Fajr. From what? From the voluntary prayer. For that, this is the merit of doing voluntary prayer more. In case if there is some shortening in your Fard, will be complete from the voluntary. And there is a lot of voluntary actually. A lot of time for the voluntary. And also, we think that the prayer, and it is for some people, alhamdulillah, perfect and good and complete, but some people still, the Fard itself, Fajr, Zuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, is heavy for them. There is more than this. There is Salat al-Hajah, there is Salat al-Istikhara, there is Salat al-Tatawwa, there is Salat Qiyam al-Layl, there is Salat al-Tahajjud, there is Salat, a lot of different kind of the Salah. A lot of different Duha, Salat al-Duha. If you neglect the Fard, then I don't think that you will do that. And another thing also. Some of the people, they will take care of the Sunan and take care very well of the voluntary doing, and they neglect the fard. This is also not right. You have to do fard first, then take care of. I'm not saying neglect whatever voluntary you want to do, but at least don't do sadaqah,
While you are not doing zakah, do the zakah first, then do sadaqah. There is no problem. Because the fard upon you is the zakah. Months of Ramadan you neglected, then you come fast Monday and Thursday. Subhanallah. Do months of Ramadan. I see some people doing that. You say, can I do the voluntary? Because voluntary is separate. But instead of whole months, I said, no, brother. Fard is fard. Fard is the one you must do it firstly. And this is the deception of Iblis. Talbis of Iblis. That he will deceive you in these things. Thinking that if you neglect of the fard, no problem. I can do voluntary. No. Do the fard must. Then after that, whatever missing of the fard, do the voluntary. Then Allah will complete it to you from whatever little bit in the fard itself. I'm saying missing of all of it, no. I'm not saying the missing of all the fard, no. But if there is little bit inside the salah itself, after you did it, was not perfect, was not complete, and you did in the tatawwa, perfect and complete, this hadith saying, فَيُكْمَلُ مَنْ تَقَصَ مِنَ الْفَرِيضَةِ أي مِنَ التَّطَوَّعِ. They will complete and perfect whatever shortening in the fard from the voluntary one. ثُمَّ يَكُونُ سَائِرُ عَمَالِهِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Listen to that careful also. It's not only for the salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying in this hadith, then the rest of his deeds will be according to that. Means more voluntary in salah, more voluntary in siyam, more voluntary in sadaqah, will complete and perfect whatever missing of the fard. And neglecting it or delaying it till the end of the day, as some of the people do, or يعني, making it habit to gather. Zuhr was Asr, Maghrib was Isha, both of them before you sleep. This is not Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Al-Ma'un, 107, ayah number 4 and 5. Allah Azza wa Jal names them Musalleen. Names them, they do the prayer. Allah does not say they are not doing, say they do. But Allah says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ هُمْ يَا اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. And ساهون, Abdullah ibn Abbas قال الذين يؤخرونها عن وقتها فويل للمصلين. Woe unto those perform a salah, but those who delay their prayer to the end of it. They delay the prayer to the end. Or delaying the prayer itself all in total to the end, which is not allowed except if you have a shar'i reason, like the qasr or jam' or traveling or rain or a war, but there is a different prayer for it, Salatul Khawf, and going on. And then in Surah Maryam, Surah number 19, ayah number 59, Allah Azza wa Jalla say, فَخَلَفَ مِن بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَوَاتِ, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud قال, هي إضاعة أوقاتها وعدم أدائها وعدم القيام بحقوقها وواجباتها. اتبعوا الشهوات أي اللذات والمعاصي فسوف يلقون غيا. قال ابن مسعود, واد في جهنم بعيد قعره خبيث طعمه. That this ayah Allah Azza wa Jal say comes after them, a people who will أضاعوا الصلاة. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud say about this word, they neglected, they did not do it perfectly, they يعني, did not do the right of it as it should be done. واتبعوا الشهوات, and they follow their own lusts, they follow their own bad desires. فسوف يلقون غيا, they will be punished in غي, a place in Jahannam. As Ibn Mas'ud say, a wadi, valley in Jahannam, it is very, very deep down, and it is very bad in everything in it. Whatever in it is very evil and very bad. And look to a warning from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to those who neglected, or to those who sometime do, sometime not, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did about them the name of kufr and shirk. The one who intentionally leaves the prayer. Rasulullah in the hadith narrated by Muslim and others also, and the hadith sahih, قال إن بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر, إن بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر, ترك الصلاة. Between man and between shirk and kufr. Here Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم named shirk and kufr. Even you will find some of the ulama who the differences. Kufr will get him out of the millah, or kufr will not get, if you can move it. Kufr will not move her from the religion. This is in differences. Why you put yourself in that? But at least Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam named it shirk and kufr. I know that there is difference. Some of them, they say that if it is intentionally different, then it is lazy. And between both of them, a lot of differences between ulama, but save yourself from being under these two titles, shirk, mushrik, or a kafir. But not only that hadith, there is a lot of other hadith about the same meaning. I'll mention only one because of the time in Tirmidhi. 2626 in Nasa'i 462, Ibn Majah 1079 in Hakim and others also. عن بريدة قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. The difference between us and them is the salah. Whoever leave it, there is no doubt the hadith does not say intentionally. But it is known that if it is intentionally, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, whoever leave it, he commit kufr. Either the kufr will get him out of the religion. Another thing, brother, also. Very important point. Suppose somebody neglected the salah. You can describe the action, saying neglecting the salah intentionally or denying it intentionally is kufr, but do not describe him. There is a person who do, and there is the act. Allowed in Islam to describe the act, not allowed in Islam to describe the person. Again, somebody denies the salah. You can say denying the salah, the action itself, you describe the action. Denying the salah is kufr, but do not say to him, denying the salah is kufr and you are kafir. No. Do not describe him. Maybe he will do tawbah. Maybe he doesn't know. Maybe he's a jahil. Maybe he will do. Allah knows. For that better way to describe the action and do not describe the person who do the same action. There is two separate things, you have to know the difference between both of them. There is the person who do, and there is the action who did. You can describe the action by saying denying the Quran is haram, denying the Quran is kufr, denying the salah is haram, denying the salah is a kufr. No problem with that. But do not describe the person who do saying that you are denying the salah, you are a kafir. No, this is not allowed. Better not to do. Except in one case. If he died with that, and was known that he doesn't do tawbah, and he never ever prays, and he dies with this way, halaka kafira. You can say that he dies with a kufr, because after this, there is no any tawbah, khalas, finished. But if he already announces tawbah, there is no any way to say anything about him. And the salah, as I said, it is must upon every Muslim in all the situation. Look to the five pillars of Islam. Bunya al-Islam ala khams. Shahada, only one time you are required. The first time when you enter Islam, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, the shahada of Islam. After that, salah, no any reason in Islam to neglect it or to leave it at all. The other three pillars in Islam, you still a Muslim and mu'min, and there is a chance to enter al-Jannah even you don't do it, if you have a shari'a reason. Like what? So, at the month of Ramadan, somebody gets sick and he continuously gets sick, there is no any sawm about him. But not decided by himself, should be by a professional Muslim doctor. Hajj, he does not have money, and he does not go. There is no any sin, and he's still a mu'min, and he's, if he does the other. And he still, if he believes in Allah, there is no any kind of shirk with the other condition, he have a chance to enter the Jannah, there is no any problem. Zakah, somebody does not have the nisab, 95 gram of gold, and less than this, and he does not pay, there is no any problem about it. For that there is excuses, shara excuses for the pillars of Islam except shahadat la ilaha illallah, no shirk, and salah. No any excuse for that at all. La uzra li tarkiha fil Islam. No any reason for leaving it. If you are not able to pray standing, Allah allow you to sit. Suppose I'm not even able to sit, Allah allow you to lay down. Even not able to pray while you are laying down, ajri arkan as-salati ala qalbik. Even you imagine that you are doing the salah on you. I'm traveling. Allah give you the qasran jam. There is a very heavy rain. Allah give you also qasran jam. If there is a war, there is a specific prayer, it's named salatul khawf. Half and half. Half of the army pray and the other half war. The one who is in war come and pray with the imam, complete it, and the one who is in salah, they go for the war. Even in war. Suppose unconscious, no excuse. When he wake up, he have to pray. When he become conscious. Suppose somebody is sleeping, but not intentionally. Does not come exactly before the time of the prayer. No. No. If he did it intentionally, he will be sinner. But if suppose he slept and taken one of the prayer, when he wake up, it is salah. Somebody forget it. forget for any reason. It was so difficult and hardship he faced. And he forgot, even remember after 10 years. He have to pray it. Or that what is the meaning? No, any excuse for leaving the prayer at all. Zakah could be if there is no any money. Sawm could be, he's not able, sick. Hajj, have no money and he's not able to go. And still he's a mu'min and Muslim and there is no any problem as long as he does not have يعني, any broken things else in Tawheed or whatever. And the chance of entering Jannah, no any problem, except that one. You will be accountable about it. No any excuse for that. You should learn the rules and the ahkam of the Salah in order to know. Even the kids. Allah Azza wa Jal order us. Hadith of Rasulullah in Abu Dawood, 494, in Tirmizi, and 407, Ad-Darqutni nazar. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say, Muru as-sabiyya ufiru abnaakum bis-salati iza balagha sab'a sanin. Order them to pray when they are getting 7 years old. But do not wait until they become 7, then you order. No, you have to teach them before that. When they start learning, start little by little and be patient with them. The only ayah in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal say, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Allah does not say, وَاصْبِرْ. قَالَ وَاسْطَبِرْ. Order your people to do the salah. Does not only say and be sabr, have sabr. No. He say, وَاسْطَبِرْ means even your sabr finished, you have to try your effort to be keeping yourself with the sabr more. Even the sabr you already have finished. Because Allah knows that they will not get it and they will not. 7 years teaching. Step by step, Al-Fatiha little bit. He pray only Allahu Akbar, then he play. He's young, no problem with that. 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 years, start now. Do not stay like as one of the sheikhs saying, one time I went to the one of the masajid and I talked to the sheikh, there is so and so and so and so wrong here. Oh, step by step, step by. He said, I went to him after 20 years. Find the same exactly. It's impossible. 20 years and there is no any changing. For that with the kids, first 7 years, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَإِذَا بَلَغَ عَشْرَ سَنِينَ فَضْرِبُوهُ عَلَيْهَا. If he get already 10 and he's still neglecting 10 years teaching and so patient, then he have to be punished. Must be punished. With whatever allowed. We are not saying punish to break his neck or break his arm. No, no. But try punishing with the way to let him know that this is important. You should not neglect it. This is your spiritual life. This is your connection with Allah Azza wa Jal. This is your protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the importance of it. One of the reasons to enter Jannah. One of the reasons also to do dua for us. It's for the parent. Nicely and with the way it makes them to love it. And makes them to do it with the love for it. Then in the same hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, فَرِّقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ. Separate them in their sleeping. This is very important. Separate them in their bed. Suppose I'm not able to bring a bed for everyone. I have 10 kids or 15 kids and I am not able. Then at least make a pillow in between them. The separation does not mean have another one. But if you are able, there is no doubt. You are able to bring a separate room for everyone. It's okay, alhamdulillah, rabbil alamin. I'm not able to bring a separate room in the same room and different beds. Suppose I'm not able to bring separate beds in the same bed, but make a pillow in between them, a long one, to be enough for anyone does not touch the other one. If you are able to make double, do you know that there is some of the beds, double, one in the first down, and there is a second. It will be good. Because suppose the room is not enough to have two beds, but at the top, you can do, there is some of the ready ones you can buy it, have two. This is also okay. But the only thing, as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فَرِّقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ. Separate them in their sleeping beds. Either buy a separate bed or buy in the same bed if you are not able, make sure that there is no any way for any one of them to touch the other one. InshaAllah, the next time, we'll go with hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, ثَلَاثَةٌ فِي ضَمَانِ اللَّهِ. Three people will be guaranteed and saved and protected and helped and secured and insured. Daman have all of this mean of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them, Rajulun kharaja ila masjidin min masajid Allah azza wa jal. A man who get out sincerely for the sake of Allah going to the masjid. This is guaranteed and saved and protected and helped and secured and insured. Daman, madmoon min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us in dunya and akhirah and accept our own good deeds and give us sincerity. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana, Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina, Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar, Allahumma arihna wa farihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna ya hayyu ya qayyum, Allahumma aj'alna muqimina lis salati wa min dhurriyatina ya hayyu ya qayyum ya arhamar rahimin, Allahumma ahdi abna'ana wa banatina ya dhal jalal wal ikram. اللهم اهد أبناءنا وبناتنا يا حي وقيوم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم قو إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا وتقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطيئتنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل وارحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم Remember us in the best of your dua and subscribe please and like it And this is, will be spreading it, and you will get a reward when you remember us in the rest of your dua. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.